how to change the default font in Microsoft PowerPoint on Windows. First thing we're going to need to do is load up PowerPoint. We'll do that. Then if we start a blank document, now you'll see there, there's nothing, there's no other slides in here. What we want to do is go to View, and we want to go across to Slide Master. This is the ribbon. So we've got the menu across the top here, and this is known as the ribbon menu here. So here, if we go to Slide Master, click that, you'll see that now expand. This is showing all the possible slides that PowerPoint has as their defaults. Now, if we go to the top, click that. Now here, this is where we can edit. This just shows all the different fonts or colors and all that kind of stuff within a particular slide. In here, we've just got the fonts. So now what we want to do is if we go to fonts, you'll see there's a drop down. If you click that and then scroll all the way down to the bottom and then customize fonts. Now there's two elements to your PowerPoint. You've got your headings and then you've got your body of the text. Now these can be two totally different fonts, or they can be fonts from the same family. So it might be bolder and more chunkier than the heading one versus the body. So I'm going to choose Poppins. What's worth bearing in mind, if you are doing PowerPoints and you choose a font and then you send that to somebody else, unless you package it with the font so that the fonts are embedded, when they open it their end, they might not see that font if it's not on their machine. So just bear that in mind. If you're doing it on your own machine, not a problem, or if they've already got access to that font. So I want a bold. Let's choose a bold, semi-bold for the headings. I'm going to choose Poppins again. Type the first couple of letters, scroll down. I'll just go with a standard for the body. And if I call this Heel Pop, Heel being my surname, Pop being the start of this. So if I save that, all I've done is just save that setting. So as you see, we've changed the font. So there's the slide master, or the master slide, where the font has been changed both for the heading and the body. And if we just scroll down and tap on the others, you'll see the fonts change throughout all the different basic slides that are available. Now what we want to do is turn this into the default template, so when we open it these fonts are embedded. So if we close that, you can see that font set we've done, it's there. So that's Heel Pop. So if there was any other slide demos you opened or and you wanted to use that particular font, that's there. Now, if I close this, we want to turn this into the default template. So if I close that, I'm going to go to design, still keeping this. So then I'm going to go to the drop down there and say save as default. Give this a name. So we'll give this Heel Pop May. Now that's saved. Now what we want to do is find where it is. So if we go across the ribbon here, just underneath, you'll see the second one there. It's got Heel Pop May. That's the one we've saved. If I right click it and say set as default, now that's it. Now that's the default template. So if we close, so if we pretend that we're starting from afresh, so if I close this, I don't want to save this. Let's close the entire application. So that's all closed. The next time we come, now let's load up PowerPoint. While that's loading, we create videos that help businesses grow online using all aspects of the internet. So if that's what you want to do, tap the subscribe button. That's all loaded. Now if we go to the default, so we go default theme, tap that, open a new window. So if I type in my name here, now this should be Poppins there. So you see it's Poppins, the ball one at that. And if I go to type in here, it should be Poppins in the body. So that straightforward, that's how you set up your default fonts. Also got videos on how you can do this in Word, Excel, and how you can also do it so you can make your productivity easier using a more advanced keyboard. So if that's something of interest, don't forget to tap subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.